Yo, Coastal Peeps, it's Oz, and I'm here today with my friend Mamoru. Hello!
Hey!
And today we're going to talk about Canada, where I'm from, versus Japan, where he's from. What shocked us when we first came to each other's country? So, Mamoru, you stayed in Canada for how long?
Half a year.
So let's talk about some things when you first went to Toronto. What's one thing you thought was weird or different?
Actually, the first things I found was I could really find a toilet in the subway station.
Okay.
Here in Japan, every station has a toilet.
Ah.
So I can find everywhere then go to toilet. And
okay. In Japan, that's true. Even the smaller stations, like the tiny stations where hardly anyone gets on or off, they have their own toilets. Talking about trains, not only just the train, but also in the street and on the, in the stations and all around, was everyone's really quiet.
Here in Japan, we have to keep us silent on the train because don't bother people.
Yeah, Japanese trains are really quiet, and 90% of the people are sleeping, right?
Right. Actually, people in Canada are not allowed to drink beer on the subway station or even in on the street.
You're only allowed to drink alcohol at licensed areas. But yeah, here in Japan, anywhere is okay,
anywhere,
right?
Even on the train.
Even on the train, that's awesome. Yeah. During the hanami, the cherry blossom, you can just sit in the park and drink. I like that rule. So something I noticed about food and drink was portions are really small. Even like if you go to McDonald's, even like the small here, it's like the baby size in Canada.
For kids,
like the kids meal size. When I go to a movie theater, for example, the extra large popcorn is like this size. And like in America, it kind of is like a giant bucket like this. You could just like
hold
it. And you get refills too.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So when you finish your popcorn in this bucket, you just bring the bucket back and they give you a refill. The drink, and they put like half of it with ice.
Yeah,
so like you only get
it.
A little bit of it. And if you say no ice, they just fill like a little bit of the cup.
Yeah.
So you can't win.
When I took a bus in Toronto, and I found sometimes a bus driver will just stop and leave the bus, even people are taking the bus, then I go to Tim Horton to get a coffee, then I come back to the...
In Japan, that would never happen?
Never, never.
Something that I noticed about Japan is uniforms. Of course, high school and junior high school people have uniforms. So the one thing about that was weird is they wear them on Saturday and Sunday, weren't every day. I feel like they have no clothes except for uniform, just 7 days a week. I noticed a lot of companies, like just regular office workers, regular like, you know, accountants or whatever, they all have their company uniform with like the logo or like different color, like they all wear like the pink shirts.
Some badges.
Or they have that like scarf.
In the rainy days, Canadians don't use an umbrella. But here in Japan, every people use umbrella in a rainy day and a snowy day. And the women in Japan sometimes use the umbrella in the sunny days.
Don't
get
sunburn. So umbrella is like all year round, right?
All year round.
Something that I found, actually not just me, my cousin actually mentioned, and I realized in Canada we just pay, you just give money, but in Japan, most places have like a tray, and they tell you the price, and then they give you the tray, and then you put the your money on the tray, and then they take it from back, and then they like give you the change.
Canada and eat a chocolate bar in the store even before paying. I saw the guy walking and then eating the chocolate bar in the convenience store or somewhere, market, and going to the line of the cashier. He pays coins, then I ate it actually, so paid $5.
That's so funny.
It's never happened in Japan because
really?
We have to, firstly, we have to pay, then I get a bar, and after that, and get out of the store, then now we can eat.
Sometimes I was so thirsty, I just I can't take it, so I open up a can of Coke and just start drinking it in the lineup. And when I get there, I just say, this Coke as well. So yeah, I guess you're right. But that doesn't happen in Japan, right?
Never.
No. Yeah.
I want to do that.
I just eat it? Yeah.
Do you think
in Japan, if you went to, for example, 7-Eleven,
uh-huh.
and you just open the drink and started drinking and then go to the line and say, kore mo, do you think they would get angry?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe the store is gonna call the police.
I haven't done that in Japan. I haven't tried. Maybe I'll try that. See what happens. Since this is summer, one thing I noticed, which was really weird, was horror movies and scary stories are really popular in the summertime. In Canada and in America, maybe, and probably in America, it's Halloween, so October is probably the best time to tell
tales.
Scary movies, or a lot of the scary movies come out in the movie theater in October, and people tell scary stories at home or whatever. But in Japan, it's summer, and I thought it's makes sense because of Obon, because Obon holiday is like the holiday for the dead, so it's kind of like Halloween,
yeah.
A little bit more serious. But what I found out was the reason Japanese people like to hear scary stories or watch scary movies in the summer is because when you're scared, you get cold, you get
cold.
Chills.
True.
Do you watch scary movies or horror stories or whatever during summer?
Yeah, of course.
And
because most of TV program provide us some horror stories on the TV.
It's supposed to cool you down.
Yeah, kind of sweat, and after that we are cooler, maybe?
Okay. So there you go, that's just some things that are different between Japan and Canada. Thanks for watching, don't forget to thumbs up if you like this video. Thank you, Mamoru, for coming on my channel again. It was a good time.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. If you haven't already, please subscribe. See you next time. Ready?
You're ready.